गुड मॉर्निंग मैडम, गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स. सो आई एम लिली पुष्पा, फर्स्ट ईयर MSc नर्सिंग, द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मेंटल हेल्थ नर्स. सो एज अ पार्ट ऑफ माय रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डील अ सेमिनार ऑन एक्सपैंडेड एंड एक्सटेंडेड रोल ऑफ द नर्स. ओके, सो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय एक्सपैंडेड एंड एक्सटेंडेड रोल ऑफ द नर्स? सो फर्स्ट विल बी डीलिंग जस्ट द इंट्रोडक्शन रिगार्डिंग ऑफ द नर्सिंग. So whenever you are dealing as a nurse, and it is a unique profession, or the nurse or the nursing, it is a unique profession. And whenever you are comparing with the other social sciences or the physicals or the any ethical components, any profession you are seeing, so the nursing is going to be considered as a unique. Okay, so why? Because and where the nurses is going to be considered as a individual and the family health promotion, health maintenance and the health problems. And where, and these nursing practice is also having a modification and changes. So in the publication evidence and also, and it is going to be affected as earlier as possible. So to enhance the research, and also it is also included in the patient care progress also. Okay, so first we'll be dealing with the extended role of the nurse. Okay, so what do you mean by extended role of nurse? So extended role of nurse means within the nursing itself, and how the nurse is going to be extend his role of nurse and extend his practice by herself. Okay, so that type of help care is called as extended role of nurse. So first one we'll deal with the caregiver. So caregiver is nothing else but, so she is going to be stand in front of the client and to give the healthcare providence to the client. And either it may be the client is having a physical or the psychological problems, and the nurse is going to be act as a caregiver, and she is going to be act as a supporter, and she is going to act as an educator, and everything she is going to be stand in front whatever the problem the client is having. So the nurse is going to be so support to the client, either physical, psychological, or the development or the spiritual levels. Okay, that type of process is called as a caregiver. And next one is a healthcare coordinator. So healthcare coordinator means the nurse is going to be act as a 24 hours per day. Yes, and the nurse, so within these 24 hours of the day, and she is going to be communicate with all the healthcare coordinators. Okay, so like for example, like as she is going to be act as a diagnostic testing, and like therapies, counseling, and patient teaching sessions, and in the giving the process of treatment. So everything in the all the aspects in the patient hospital, when the patient is in the hospitalization, and she is going to be serves as a care of the patient. Okay, so that is called as healthcare coordinator. And next one is a advocate. Okay, so advocate means whatever the rights of the patient is there, and the nurse is going to be use some of the knowledge and technologies and to take the responsibility of the patient, and she is going to be stand behalf of the patient, and she is going to be take up that work, and for the sake of health promotion of the client. So that is called as a advocate. Okay, and next one is a educator. Okay, whatever the client is having some of the problems, okay, in the hospitalization, and she is going to be act as a educator to the patient as well as the family members. Okay, so for example, like and regarding of the health condition and regarding of the procedure what they are going to do in the hospital, and everything she is going to be give a clear cut information to the client and their family members. And also she is going to be act as an educator as a dietary management and also grieving. So dietary management means what type of food and what type of so dietary, nothing else but food supplementation the client has to take and according to the disease conditions. And also grieving means and whatever the problems the client is having, and the nurse is going to be shows the solution for the problem. Okay, that is a educator. And next one is a communicator. Okay, so in the hospital the nurse is only the best communicator to the client. Whatever the problem the client is having, and the client is going to be makes the trust towards the nurse, and whenever the nurse is going to be communicate with the client, so because and she is only the healthcare provider continuously be beside of the client. Okay, so how much of communication the nurse can the how much of the therapeutic communication so that the nurse can able to give, either in the verbal form, either in the written form, either non-verbal form, so the client will have the trust, and whatever the problem the client is having and everything, the client is going to be exhibit to the nurse. Okay, so that type of is called as a communicator, and the communication should be only as a therapeutic. So therapeutic means what? So only, so as a healthcare working only, so the nurse has to work. Okay, and next one is a manager. So manager means, and these manager, and manager means managing everything, the knowledge and skills of the patient. Okay, the patient needs and the organization, patient assignments and whatever the work and evaluation. Okay, so everything the nurse is going to be managers, either with the client works and organization works and the doctors and the diagnostic works, and everything the nurse is going to be coordinated with the client, and that process is called as a manager. And next one is a counselor. So what is the work of the counselor means, and he will help the client to recognize and cope with the stressful activities. So means whatever the client is having, any psychological problems or the social problems, and first the client, the counselor will identify the problem. Yes, and he will make some interpersonal relationship, and he will identify the problem, and he will analyze the interpretations, and the psychotherapist will be and giving some of the new attitude, feelings and behavior towards the performance of client, and that promoting intellectual growth of the client. So the nurse is going to act as a counselor also in order to recognize the client problems. Okay, and whatever the client problems they are having, and she will be showing an alternative choice for the patient. Okay, and next one is a change agent. So change agent means, so in the process of nursing care, the development is very very essential. Okay, during the care process, and the client needs an essential care, and that the nurse is going to be develop herself, and how much of essential care the client needs and everything, the nurse will change first, and then she will give the care to the person. What modification extent she can do, so that much first she is changing his own behavior and training herself and giving a continuation care to the patient. Okay, and next one is a leader. Okay, so leader means what? She will standing in front of the client, either individual client and the family group and the client's colleagues or the community effective leadership, and she is going to make a interpersonal relationship with all others, and she is finding out the problem of the client, family, community and the colleagues. So she is going to act as a leader. And next one is a research consumer. Okay, so research consumer means an enhancing a descriptive knowledge on the subject. Okay, and she is enhancing some of the new skills and the new inventions also in the nursing. She is going to be practice based nursing, she is going to be prepared as a nurses. Okay, so whatever the client problems are there, and to enhance the client care, and she is doing some of the identifying of the researchable problems, and she will be collecting the data, and she will be clarifying the information. Okay, and according to the scientific knowledge only, the nurse is going to be give the nurse or the scientific researcher. Okay, and next one is a collaborator. So collaborator means what? And this collaboration has a four elements, nothing else but sharing a common interest and collaborating effort, and ground rules for the effort, and the structure within which efforts takes place. And these four elements is going to be depend on the patient care problem only. Okay, so nothing else but the nurse is going to be communicate with the other care team members. Okay, and she is going to be expectancy lengthy care, healthy care provided towards the patient. So that process is called as a collaborator. Okay, and so these are the extended role of nurse, and second one we'll be dealing with the expanded role of nurse. Okay, so expanded role of nurse means, so other than our clinical profession towards a direct client care, so it is we can say that indirect nursing care also we can say. So that is that other hand or specific roles in employment positioning. okay, not only the nursing, and there are so some more educational and experiences also there in our nursing responsibilities, okay. And then we'll go for the definition of the expanded role of nurse, okay. So expanded means what? Increased responsibility in the practice area, and also greater autonomy is going to be taken place by the person, okay. So nothing else but not only the nursing care profession directly or indirectly also we can given care in different departments of the person, okay, in the nursing profession. So that part is called as expanded role of nurse, okay. So first one will be dealing directions for expanded role of nurses. So here you see the direction, two types of directions, that is outward direction and inward direction. So outward directions, other sector, that nothing else but in the process of care, okay, that is nurses are moving from the curative sector into community for supporting primary health care, like in the PHC centers, okay, and in school health nursing services and maternal and child health nursing services and occupational health nursing services. So these are the outward services. So inward services means, so direct care of the client, okay, and client may be individual or the family. So these type of care is called as outward and inward expanded role of nurse. So what are the factors that are influencing in the expanded role in the nursing, okay? So what is saying that, so the health is not only the part of the overall the nurses or the doctors of the healthcare professions. So it is a fundamental rights of the citizen. So if the citizens are not about to so help to the healthcare systems, okay, and automatically the changes in the healthcare department is also going to be taken part, okay. And next one is the transition of healthcare system from disease oriented model to health oriented model is a emerging trend. So what they are saying that, so previously, so the comparing with the previous sectors and the present sectors, and the present sector having a more health oriented models and how they are going to improve your health process, okay. So precautions they are going to give you, so instead of already getting of disease conditions and before getting of decisions, and they are going to give the profession, okay, and sorry, precautions they are giving. And next is a specialization in other developmental implications of nursing practices. So not only in a process of care, and the nurse is also going to be take part in the nursing practices. So if you have the specialized nursing practice only, so you can able to give a proper care. So if you don't have a well practiced, so you are not going to be enhance the situation, okay. And next, the need of the nurses experts to utilize their expertise for the care the client. So what they are saying that, so if the nurse is expertized in certain categories, okay, certain departments, so the nurse has to be work in certain departments only. So if she is concentrating on the other department and she is not able to care with the other considerations, okay. And next we are going to see that different types of the expanded role of nurse, okay. And in that, first one is a nurse clinician, okay. So nurse clinician means, so the nurse is going to be act as a clinical and individual and in the scientific knowledges, okay. For example, a direct delivery of personal healthcare service to the patient. So either in the process of two types, okay. So for example, now as a clinician means what? So directly either in a clinical area or the schools. So we'll see these types. The first one is assistant clinical director, okay. So assistant clinical director means the nurse is going to be in a university hospitals or the clinical faculty appointment, and she is going to act as a clinicians, means giving a small type of care, like for example appointment in the schools of nursing as a nurse. And next one is a joint appointment, okay. A joint appointment means has a responsibility of a teacher and guiding a group of students, okay. So giving a instructions and how to do all the nursing practices, and they are going to act as a nurse clinicians, okay. And next one, what is their function of the nurse clinician means, so what is a care, first one is a care function, means palliative care, physical care, protective care and the mental health care. So palliative care means what? Whatever the symptoms they are having, so to comfort their pain, and they are going to be use the care, that type of care is called as an palliative care, alleviating pain and providing comfort as far as possible. And physical care means like you have to explain the hygienic needs, what is the nutrition they have to take and what type of exercises they have to do. And the protective care means and a safe environment and possible complications. And mental health care means and needs of the patient, whatever the needs of the patient, self-care, everything they have to provide it. Okay, so that part is called as a care function. Next one is a cure function. So cure function means has a clinical management. Okay, so as a nurse and she whatever the work she will be doing in the hospital, and that type of work, therapeutic work, is called as a cure function. Like for example, data collection, assessment, planning, implementation and evaluation. And third part of the nursing clinician is counseling, means psychological support and teaching a patient and family members and giving a guidance and restoration of the family health and maintenance of the health. So in this part, the nurse is going to act as a nurse clinician. Okay, so what are the sub roles of the nurse clinician? And she is going to act as a clinician, as a teacher, as a researcher, leader, coordinator and the role model. Okay, so for example, staff and the students. Okay, so as a teacher and the students, the teacher is a role model for the students. Okay, so that type of nurse clinician roles. Okay, and second one is a nurse practitioner. Okay, so nurse practitioner means, so the nurse and she has to do master degree in the nursing, so then only she will be having the education in pharmacology and also the physical assessment and certification, and an expertise in the specialized area of practice is very very essential. So because of extent knowledge, okay, and if she has extent knowledge and she can able to manage the functioning of the nurse practitioner. So how, what she can do means, so the nurse practitioners are educated to perform a broad spectrum of function. So in that, what is making, first one is she will be helpful in history taking and health assessment she will give, and also in that, in the framing of diagnosis it will be helpful, and the management of acute minor ailments like for example fever, vomiting and everything she can able to manage, and also management of chronic conditions also. Okay, like for example respiratory diseases, all kind of things she is going to be enhanced, and laboratory test also she can able to having an idea, and she can prescribe medication, she can be done at limited levels, and initial continuing and discontinuing treatment she will be having an idea, and secondary level of health care and health education she can give, and maintain records and reports, and some preventive and curative rehabilitations and maintenance and restoration of the health of client, and parish health areas also she can able to go, and she can able to identify the problems of the community. Okay, and so in the community sector, and she is going to act as a agencies of women's and children's, and has a psychiatric clinics and some dispensaries, and like a small like immunization areas also they can work, and like rehabilitation centers, daycare centers, like orphanage or geriatric health care centers, and emergency and acute care. So in these areas, so the nurse practitioner is going to be works, and if she have done a master degree in his profession. Okay, and next one is a nurse counselor. So nurse counselor means whatever the demands and the complaints of the client and the family members are having, so first the nurse is going to be divided the problems into the short term goals and the long term goals. So if it is a short term goals are there, and the nurse is going to be guide the individual, and so she will solve the problem. If it is a long term means, so she will make through the hands and she will use some of the tools, and until the problem solves, and she is going to be, so be with the patient and be active listener, and she will be solving the problem of the client. Okay, and next one is a telenursing. So telenursing means, and what if, for example, it's an advanced technology of the telenursing, and where, so what in the population, and if there is any problem to the persons, and automatically, and so the client is directly is going to be get the information regarding of the problem solution. Okay, and for example, some using protocols, algorithms and guidelines to assess and address the client needs systematically, and prioritizing the urgency of the client needs, and developing a collaborative plan for care with the client and the support systems, and also evaluating outcome of practice and care. So means, for example, here and soon after the so healthcare systems, they will go home and they will be staying. So in that part, and through the telecommunication only, so they can able to so get the information by the nurses. Okay, and what and how the which type of care they have to take, and immediate care they can get by through one telehealth nursing practice. Okay, so that is the main communication they can make easily, and immediate care we can give for the management and the care coordination. And okay, so especially in the counseling process and the guidance process, and these tele nursing is very very important. And next one is a telemedicine. So telemedicine means what? A delivering of healthcare services to the distance members. Okay, so healthcare professions, and giving an information and communication technologies to diagnose, to treatment, and to prevent the disease. And these telemedicine is essential. Okay, and also, and in our education and systemic of care, and this telemedicine is advanced health of individual and their communities also. Okay, and where the World Health Organization only has been defined these type of telemedicine technologies, and to enhance the care, continuous care for the disease induced and for the diagnosis of the patients. Okay, and a certified nurse midwifery. So certified nurse midwifery means what? So different, providing an independent care for the woman during normal pregnancy, labor of delivery, and care of newborn. And she has to be specialized as a midwife. Okay, and whatever the process is there. So in a, like for example, like family planning, some treating of minor vaginal infections, everything she has to be practiced in the nurse. So if she can practiced only, and you have to give a certified nurse midwifery, and to provide the collaborative management referral services in the nursing profession. Okay, and next one is a certified registered nurse anesthetist. Means so the anesthesiology, and anesthesiology means and so advanced practice of the anesthetic, means anesthetist, like nothing else but pre-operative visit and post-operative, so status of the client, and they have to be identified. Okay, and next, nurse educator. So already we have discussed that the nurse is going to be act as a educator. So because and whatever the students has to be learned that in the school of nursing or the college of nursing, and or in the community areas or in the hospital sectors, and the nurse is going to be act as a educator. So if once the nurse is educator, and the fulfillment of practice skills and theoretical knowledge, everything they are going to enhance. So then only the advanced clinical experiences the nurse is going to be taken part. Okay, and next one is a nurse researcher. So nurse researcher means in a master degree in nursing, so compulsory, so they have to set up a master degree of research, they have to be fulfilled. Okay, and to improve the skills of the nursing capability. And next one is a nurse administrator. So administrator means managing all the experiences, educations, and the supervision the nurse is going to be taken care as a client care. And next one is a nursing entrepreneur. Okay, so the nursing entrepreneur, nothing else but so in a business. Okay, so degree and manages a health related business, like for example, like in education, in a consultation or research factors. Okay, so that the nursing entrepreneurs is going to be helpful. Next one is a operating room nurse. So operating room nurse means, see, whatever the patients are admitted before or after the surgery, and the nurse is going to be act as a monitor. Okay, attending staff and before the surgery and after the surgery, like pre-operative nurse. Okay, and next one is a rehabilitation nurse. So already you know that rehabilitation teams are educator, consultants, and the so liaisons within the organizations and the communities. So these type of the rehabilitation nurse will be acting as a research and help apply findings of the client. So how much extent the client rehabilitation process is going to be taken place. And next one is a travel nurse. So this travel nurse, whenever the in the traveling process the nurse will act, she will be joining in the so traveling process, and she will give care, and after that, and she will be so assigning the regular job in the process. How many hours she will be there means 13 to 20 hours, and she will be working in the traveling nurse. Okay, and next one is a critical care nurse. So critical care nurse means, as usual, you know that, and performing a basic client care, like for example in ICUs and the emergency cares. Okay, like administration and maintaining medication and IV fluids, and identifying a cardiac arrhythmias. Okay, and giving of a CPR and the defibrillation, physical assessment, interpretations and the ordinary diagnostic test, health teaching, identifying community resources and the monitoring of the hemodynamics. Okay, for example, like a arterial blood glass analysis. Okay, these type of part they are going to enhance us. And next one is a nurse author. So nurse author means, and the nurse is going to be, so act as she is going to be publish their own journals. Okay, and the nurse educator both in the schools and the colleges, and she will do a thesis and submit the material for the publication in a professional journal. So that part is called as a nurse author. And next one is a palliative care nursing. So palliative care means, so whenever you are alleviating the symptoms without curing, means disease you may not cure, but the symptoms you can able to cure. For example, in the cancer, so extent of cancer you may not cure, but the symptoms and the signs and symptoms of the patient you can able to cure. So that part is called as a palliative care. And nurse oncologist means, and treating with the cancer diseases. Okay, diagnosing of cancer and working as a cancer specialist nurse is called as a nurse oncologist. And next, intrastromal therapist. So intrastromal therapist means the nurse who works in an endoscopy room, infection control nurse is called as a intrastromal therapist. And next one is a trauma care specialist. So trauma care specialist means emergency room. Okay, and the persons who met with an accident and a heart attack and a different kind of the medical problems, emergency problems, and the nurse is going to be specialized in emergency hospitals. And next one is a community health care or public health nurse. That is, first one is a occupational health nurse. So occupation means what? So within the occupations, she is going to be act as a programmer, counselor, employees, coordinating health promotion activities, and what type of support they have to take in a business, everything the nurse is going to be act in the occupation. And hospital nurse, so already you know that, and providing a when the patient is ill, so who will come to the hospital and they are making a health promotion curing is called as a hospital nurse. And home health care nurse. So home health care nurse means, so in the home itself, and if any disabled person are there, so they need a continuous care in the home itself only. So in that process, and the nurse is going to be in the beside of the patient in the home sectors. And school nurse means, and in the whatever the problem the child is having, the basic simple problem like communicable diseases and these type of first aid, so the nurse is going to be activated. Okay, and the last one is a nursing informatics. Okay, so nursing informatics means the nurse also should have the knowledge regarding of the knowledge regarding computer. Okay, so like communicating data, information and knowledge in nursing practice. So why? Because whatever the data is going to be there, so that she has to be, so in that she has to be, so interpreted in the computer science and information science to manage the overall the data connections. Okay, so what is the data connection responsibilities means, first they have to system analysis and designing they have to do, and developing of data dictionaries and evolutions and testing of applications for patient care, configuration of hardware and software they have to know, and translating the language of nursing to engineers, and system designing and vice versa they have to take a responsible, and using application software and computer network, and installing and maintaining a hardware and software, and programming is one or more computer system responsibilities, and they have to analyze and evaluate the information requirement. Okay, and to the team members also. And next one is to solve the patient problem, the computer is also very very important, and for the safety and the privacy, and so this computer is going to be acts. Okay, so that is regarding of overall expanded role of nurse. Okay, so still now we deal with the extended and expanded role of nurse. And coming to the summary, so today we have discussed the expanded and expanded role of nurse, and what is the definition and some professional responsibilities and the role of nurse and some factors influencing expanded role and extended role and what is the various practices in the health sector. So why we are learning these means and to enhance the knowledge for the nurses to practice and join in different health sectors of their roles. So we are going to deal this expanded and expanded role of nurse. Okay, and what is the conclusion of this means? So we have covered much ground in the area of nursing roles. So we can see the nurses has become bigger, fuller and more elaborated or systemic and more mature in the current time. So by expanding the nurses role help and then taking their own initiatives, doing their own thinking and making their own decisions by on their experiences and education and to improve their practice for the benefit of patients, okay, and the client. Okay, so this is regarding of expanded and extended role of nurse. Thank you.